Hey everyone, it's Dr. Russell. I hope you're having a great week so far, and this is just after Thanksgiving, so I hope you have a nice full belly and got lots of rest for this holiday. So this week I wanted to talk about something that we tend to see more this time of year, and that is seasonal affective disorder. Now, this tends to happen sometime in the fall through winter, and it occurs around the time when we have the weather change, so it gets gloomier outside. Of course, today when I'm filming, it's nice and sunny out, but in general, it gets more gloomy, we have more rain, and shorter days, so less sunshine throughout the day. And as far as how many this affects, it really can range. There is a variance as far as people, and it seems to really depend on where you live. So in places like Florida in the south, where it's more sunny, it's maybe 1% of the population. As we get farther north, I saw some statistics for New Hampshire, it was up to 9% of the population. So in Maryland, where I'm at, obviously we're somewhere in the middle. So maybe it's 5%. It's hard to say. But people that already have a mood disorder, like bipolar or depression, they are more likely to suffer from seasonal affective disorder. So it is something that you might be more prone to if you already have an underlying mood condition. So it can look different ways, but it really is just the acronym seasonal affective disorder, SAD. So you can feel kind of down. You might have a loss of motivation, maybe loss of energy, just feeling depressed, loss of interest in things. You might also have issues with sleep. So maybe you're sleeping more, like almost you want to go into hibernation mode, or you might have disrupted sleep and having a harder time sleeping, and even things like appetite changes. So all things we normally associate with depression. It just happens seasonally. And then once we get to spring, you feel better and you're fine. So can really, again, vary as far as symptoms. So I wanted to talk about a few tips today that can help you if you are someone that does have seasonal affective disorder. So first thing, my number one thing that I always like to evaluate for people is vitamin D status. So there have been studies that have shown that when people that are low in vitamin D are given vitamin D supplementation, it does help their mood with seasonal affective disorder. Now, some studies found that if you weren't low, it didn't really seem to make much of an impact. So I always recommend getting your vitamin D tested to make sure that you either need supplementation or just a maintenance dose or whatever that looks like. But for most labs, optimal, we're going for 60 to 80. And most people I see, if they're taking maybe a little bit, they're around 30. So people are about half where they should be. So, you know, definitely want to get that checked. The other great supplement that seems to be really helpful is melatonin. So as I mentioned, your sleep can be disrupted with seasonal affective disorder. So using a little bit of melatonin at night can help kind of reset that circadian rhythm. And what they did find in some studies is that it did help people with their mood and some increase in mood and energy and motivation. So not a bad thing to try. Melatonin is that hormone that's released when we sleep. So or to make us sleep, definitely want to take it at night. And, you know, with everything, always check with your doctor to make sure that it is safe for you to use, because there are some conditions where you don't want to take melatonin per se. I usually start people around 3 milligrams or so, and then people can work up if they need to. And then the last supplement that has been shown to be somewhat effective, again, it really can depend, is tryptophan. So tryptophan is an amino acid that is converted to serotonin. And we usually think of serotonin in depression. Granted, there are other things that affect depression, but that is one connection there. And then serotonin becomes melatonin. So melatonin, that's what we're taking. So you can see that kind of helps set up that pathway from tryptophan to serotonin to melatonin. So usually we do in gram dosages. It just really, again, you want to make sure that it's safe for you to take. Anyone that's already on an antidepressant like SSRI, you don't really want to take tryptophan. So again, that one I would definitely check with your doctor on to be safe. So those are 3 supplements. Now I have 3 kind of more lifestyle things that you can do. So first thing, and this might sound a little crazy, is to go outside. So to actually get outside, again, even if it's not sunny or the weather's kind of crappy, just get outdoors and do something outdoors. Even if it's a little walk around the block or, you know, tending to your dying garden, whatever is preparing your garden for next year, just getting out a little bit can actually really help boost your mood. The second thing that kind of can tie in or overlap with getting outside is moving. So doing some exercise, doing some activity. So whether again it's walking or indoors like yoga or running up and down the stairs or something just to get your heart rate up actually can help improve your mood. And then the last thing that you might have heard of with seasonal affective disorder is using a light box. So a light box helps to just give our brain that sensation that we have more light, again, since it's usually not as sunny out, and it can help set up their circadian rhythm so that way you can get better sleep at night. So ideally, I usually recommend doing it in the morning, maybe about 20 or 30 minutes when you first get up, to really signal to the brain, okay, it's daylight, it's time to be alert and energized and ready to go. But that can be really effective for some people, especially if it does affect your quality of life. So that 20 to 30 minutes is not a bad investment of time. So we had three supplements, three lifestyle things. Hopefully that was helpful information. I'd love to hear if you've had experiences with this, if you suffer with this. I know I do better with sunny weather from I think because of where I'm from, but you know, sometimes it can get kind of hard when it does feel like it's gloomy for days and days and days. So some of these things have been helpful for me as well, but I'd love to hear from you, and I hope you have a great rest of the week, and I will see you in 2 weeks with another video.